could well be hers here, because Kadair surely is not going to be able to muster the sort of speed that Gunzebi Dibaba can. As they approach the bell, Dibaba moves back into the lead. Kadair in second place. Helen Mabiri, the world champion, in third. And Dibaba stretches away. Kadair will do her best to hang on to her. Dibaba still hasn't quite broken her young teammate. And it's going to be another hard race for Dibaba, and that lead just extending with every single stride. Down the back straight, Kadair doing her best, but she just doesn't quite possess the pace of Dibaba. But she will get stronger, and one day she may well be able to stay with her and even run away. But if she leaves it until the last 400 metres, this is what's going to happen. Dibaba can do this to anybody when she's on top form. It's still going to be a pretty quick clocking here, despite that very slow second kilometre. Gunzebi Dibaba, as the crowd rise, stretching away here. She's going to shatter the world lead. Nobody's run under 15 minutes so far this year. She may well get under 14:30 here. Gunzebi Dibaba wins the 5,000. 14:26 today. Might be just inside a personal best in second place, and Helen Obiri has to settle for third. Well, Dibaba asked for the race to be set up for a 14:10 run. There was nowhere near that once that second kilometre was as slow as it was. She did pick it up through three, third kilometre, asked her teammate to do a bit of work, which she did heroically. And then Dibaba did what she does best, just turns on the burners. Didn't really have to extend as quick as she sometimes capable of, but Gunzebi Dibaba, more than enough for Kadair. In fact, Kadair has been rewarded with a personal best, not by much, just shaving her best by a couple of seconds for 14:30.29 for the 20-year-old. So Gunzebi Dibaba wins 14:26.89, personal best for Kadair. Season's best for Obiri, certainly looking a lot better than we saw her in Doha. Season's best for